Welcome everyone. We have learnt about how the circle of friends strategy is used in inclusive education in the previous video. Another effective instructional strategy used in inclusive education is the blended learning. This video is the first part of a two-part series where we will learn about the concept and models of blended learning. The blended learning is a teaching style that consists of both traditional instructions combined with online and digital instructions. The British Educational Communications and Technology Agency defines blended learning as a combination of face-to-face and online delivery, which suits a wide range of learning styles. So, face-to-face learning along with online learning gives us blended learning. There are different models of blended learning. Let's try and understand them. The first model is called as the rotation model. Students rotate from one learning activity to the other, related to the topic being studied in the same classroom. For example, they may have a paper-pencil activity, a group activity, which primarily is a face-to-face activity between students, and an online activity using computers and internet. There are four subtypes of this model. The station rotation model, the lab rotation model, flipped classroom, and the individual rotation model. Let's find out more about these subtypes. We begin with the station rotation model. Here, the classroom is divided into different stations, like the teacher-led instructions, collaborative or cooperative learning group activities, and computer-based instructions. The students are also divided into groups, and each group rotates between the stations in the same classroom. The teacher gives directions regarding which group will engage in which activity. Next, the lab rotation model. This is very similar to the station rotation. However, here the students rotate and go to a computer lab for online learning activities instead of staying in the same classroom. So the other activities which do not require online, that is done in the classroom, and for the online activity, they go to the lab. The next one is the flipped classroom. The main content which the teacher normally teaches in the classroom is sent online to the students to study at home as homework. During the actual school hours, the teacher saves time in giving direct instructions and instead uses the time to discuss any doubts or make students practice or gives project. Since the students have already learnt about the concept at home, the teacher may also conduct detailed discussions like the application of the concept that they have learnt. In the individual rotation model, the teacher or maybe an algorithm or a set timetable instructs individual students, and remember, not groups, but individual students, to do the activities in the class as per the individual student's needs. The student may not do all the activities which the peers do, like in the station or lab rotation model, where the entire group was doing the particular activity which the teacher was asking them to do. Here, individually, the students are asked to do specific activities. So some students may go for the intervention and others may go for a project and so on. This is something like the IEP or individual education plan that is used in inclusive education. Let's go back to our diagram. So these were the subtypes of rotation model, that is the station rotation, lab rotation, flipped classroom and individual rotation model. This is all coming under the first model, which is the rotation model. The second model is the flex model. In the second model, it consists mainly of online instructions. However, this is done in the school and in the presence of the teacher. The students have the freedom to move between activities according to their interests and needs. The third model is known as a la carte model. The students can choose and pick online courses to supplement what they are learning in their regular school classes. It's like add-on courses. A la carte is a menu card in French. So just in like in restaurants, you go and you can choose the dishes from the menu card. Here, the students can choose the online courses, and that's why it is called a la carte model. The last model, or the fourth model, is the enriched virtual model. An enriched virtual model uses online learning as the primary place for study. Students learn virtually online from wherever they wish, but they require to have in-person learning sessions with their teachers. That means students need to attend contact lectures with their teachers along with the online course. So, these are the various models of blended learning. Hence, blended learning is a flexible strategy which allows the teacher and learners to use various teaching learning activities along with online devices. These are some references. You can visit and read more about the topic. I hope this video was helpful. See you in the second part of the series. Thank you for watching.